Once again, I have one of the best basketball players ever to touch the court. Also one of the greatest human beings to talk to off the court. Rolando Blackman, how you doing, sir?
I'm well, too. Thank you. I'm glad to be here, too.
All right. Great, great, great. So just for starters, Panama. How does Panama and basketball meet? Like, that's a unique thing.
Yeah, well, it's just a family story. Everybody migrated from Panama, Barbados, Grenada, Jamaica. That's where all my family is from. And I was born in Panama City. And my grandmother petitioned for me when I was a little boy. And at the age of 5, I got that student visa to come into New York City. And that's where it all started, where I got a chance to get my education and then started on the basketball, after playing soccer, of course.
What do you miss most about being on the court? Now, you're obviously involved in basketball still, but what do you miss about being on the court?
On the court, the camaraderie with the players. I think anytime you get a chance to meet so many different people, get a chance to spend so much time, the gruel, the successes, the losses, and being around them even more than your family most of the time as you go through a 7 to 8 month period of time, I think I miss that the most, just the camaraderie with the players and understanding that kind of a opportunity to be able to do something and try to make something worthwhile with a group of men.
All right, so LeBron James is in year 15. And me and you talked about this. I think we talked about this a few years back. And we were like, man, if he's able to do this at year 15, it's unheard of. Now he's in year 15 doing the exact same thing. What do you think about him as a player? I mean, you obviously play the same position as a small forward in that wing area. What do you think about him as a player, like the evolution of the game, just him in general?
The thing about him is that he's one of the greatest to play the game. You know, for me, he's playing a different position because he's playing the small forward. He's playing the big forward. He's playing the point guard. He's trying to do those kind of things that are exceptional to the game, and he's exceptional in every phase of the basketball game. Not only can he score, but also he can pass. He can set the whole team up to being able to be at the high level that they need to be in order to play. You know, anytime somebody has been to the finals, I think it's 7 times in a row, I think it's just a tremendous statistic that people don't even gather in their minds what they're looking at and understanding where this guy has pulled his basketball team. But I would put him as a combination of between Magic and a combination of him and Magic and Jordan. That's where I would put him in the middle of those kind of guys, too, because he can score very, very well, and he can dime very well also, too, and put himself in the proper place.
What would you consider him for as, like, in your era? Would he be a guy that could obviously adjust to your era of basketball when it's more physical?
Yeah, but he's a big, strong guy. I mean, you talk about physical force that he uses now. He would have no problem whatsoever in this era or in the era before, simply because he could adapt to that. You know, you had guys like Magic Johnson playing the game in that way, rolling, running, passing the basketball, going to the cup, and he can elevate higher than him just like Jordan could. So he'd adapt just fine and would have been the same kind of player he is today.
All right, last question. You always mention education. You're really big on education. Why is education important for a basketball player? Because you mentioned that to the kids. I've been around you where you talk to kids about that. Why is that important for a basketball player?
Well, it's always important to get a great education simply because you want also to develop the mind. Anytime you're going through a social system and just playing the game of basketball is just one small facet of it. You've got to be able to develop your mind, understanding not only the parameters to being able to make yourself better, but to understand exactly what your future is about and try to always build and build and build. Not only for basketball, but you really must become a student athlete in the greatest sense if you're going to be able to do that. But if not, you've got to be able to develop your mind and understand the consequences of society if you don't build yourself on an educational level. You've got to start with education, plow through the education, and really understand that that's where your best bet comes from. No matter if you go through in what you're trying to study or not, you've got to have an educational background so that you can adapt to things later on in your life.
All right, Rolando, well, you know I always appreciate it. You know, you're one of the staples in basketball history. I want you to know that you may look at yourself as just one of the guys, but trust me, I've seen people who see you, and they get in awe to this day. So it's always an honor for myself, you know, to always talk to you on the daily about basketball, and it's always a pleasure. And I just wish for you the best going forward, you know.
Thank you so much, yes, too. Sir. It's always an honor and a pleasure to talk to you, and it's a great situation, too. We're all about society and basketball, yes, and we want to do the very best we possibly can.
All right, thank you.